wish I could take a machine gun too. The fuckers that are hammering away all day in the fucking renovation apartment. That noise is really obnoxious. Right. Second attempt to make this work. Let's see if I can plug in this into power cable. At least I can do that. Okay, I'm now to set the data cable to. Okay, and we should be in business with that. So now the remaining power cables. To install are the two that go to the motherboard. And then I need to install the fans into the motherboard, and then I need to install the front panel connectors into the motherboard, and once we do that, if I did everything right up until that point, we should be good to go. So let me get started on that. First, I need to route big ass ATX cable. So that I can put that where it belongs. This one right here that I'm pretty sure you can't see because you I'm horrible at this, so you can't see anything. This thing needs to go plugged in right into the motherboard, but it's only half of what powers it. Apparently I will be able to route this properly at least, but I will need to take a closer look to see which of these, or which orientation this needs to take. I'm not sure there's an easy way to tell, but I'll need just take a closer look. And half of what powers the motherboard is plugged in. Now I believe I need the other one, which should be PCI. At least according to the manual, yeah. It needs to be PCI, 12 volts. So let me see. How do I power this? Thank you. Oh, well, I might have something to take on the front panel connector thingy, which is on hand right now. Just a thing that's gonna supply power to the USB. USB 3.0 ports that I have. I also have the little LED and switch connectors, but I think I'm gonna leave those for last. So, yeah. Let me see, this is the USB 3.0 one, and there's the LED ones, they're tiny as you can see. And I think this one's for another fans. If not for something else, but... but either way, we start off by... Well, I would hold this thing up to the motherboard, but there's really no way I can position that. In such a way that you can actually clearly see what's going on, so I will just do this. And I believe... end result will be worth it. Alright, I've just plugged in the front USB 3.0 connectors, which... these are one of those things you gotta plug into a bunch of pins, which are small and fragile, so I was kind of antsy about that, but I think I did it right. And now I will try to do the PCI Express to the other motherboard power slot, like I said it was. That song. Oh, that's the song. Okay, so I got a couple of extra PCI stuffs, which are the same as the one that went into the GPU. So let me see if I can. I think I'm gonna have to not route those because I don't think that's gonna leave me with enough room. Also, that's a bit louder than expected. That's, you know, a Russian song. Also, hey, default time. Hopefully, on the final stages of building this new rig of mine that you can't see. Because I have it in hand, and I gotta work closely with it. Alright, I think I've got both of the power connectors connected to the motherboard at last. So now with all of that stuff that I've done, all that remains are the rest of the front panel connectors, which are the ones for the switches and the LEDs. Got an extra PCI thing that's not plugged into anything that I'm gonna have to set aside somehow. And fans, of course, the front panel connectors and the fans. So let me get started on those, and then, well, I'd like to show you, but so I can see. As you can't see. This would actually be the correct term. Also, I can't recognize this music. Oh, it's this French dude singing. It's actually kind of appropriate for this. Let's see. Well, the fan wires look like this. I guess you could say there's a couple of fans you can plug them into something that powers them. You can use a Molex adapter to wire them into the power supply directly, but that has the effect of always having them run at full speed, regardless of whether they need to or not. And I think if you... it's not quite as efficient energy-wise as plugging them into the motherboard, which is a standard way, but if you do that, then the motherboard will regulate the speed depending on the temperature of the case as a whole, so I think I'm going to plug them into the motherboard. I have two fans, yes, two, one front and one back, and three connectors, so I'm going to work them into those. I just need to figure out where they are, because I've got most of my stuff covered up already. Okay. And do more cable management. Management still with this. All this stuff's gonna have to go over the video card. And most of the stuff's... Yes, most of the fan connectors are under it. Let me... To confirm or deny this. Okay, there's one. The topmost one is... to the left of the RAM slots. Okay, so I don't actually have to. To route this one or pass it over the video card, but what I do have to do is figure out which way it goes plugged in, because the notch faces one way. And I can't tell which way is supposed to face the notch on the motherboard, because I can't see anything like always, so one moment. And I've just done that for the front fan as well, with another one that was closer, so the fans are plugged in, so last thing. Unless there's something else. Oh, this is the audio, I forgot about that. Well, two last things. Just plug in the audio and plug in the front panel connectors, and then if I plug this in and the lights turn on, then we'll be in business. Thank you. The audio is in, and now on the off. See that mic is on. And, well, that's kind of why I wanted to have this, you know, in hand earlier, because I know that he does understand to start earlier on Monday, so I wanted to have this ready before then, but that's alright. It's okay, I just need to go and figure out which. Okay. Yes, I got all the power connected to all things except the only thing that I don't have plugged yet is the front panel connectors, but to that, yeah, there we go. Need to get that page of the manual because it's kind of unclear if you just try to look at it directly. Got it. So all I gotta do now is figure out which of these I'm gonna go first. What power button? That's important. One for the power switch is looking at it. It is. Is it? Okay, there it is. Is the second one in from the left on the top row? And positive is on the left hand. Right. So let me attempt this. Should be connected to the motherboard. Now let's see what's left of that. It's a power LED. So, Alright, got it half done. It's incredibly tricky to do this because fucking things are so tiny and there's not a lot of space, but I'm managing. I only got the reset switch to go, which apparently is somewhere else. Switch is... Okay, no, never mind. It's right. My bad. It's right next to the other one, but... opposite polarity of the other ones. Good. It's minus and then plus. Oh.
Isn't Bungling Brothers burn out of bailing circus? Never mind. Well, what have you got to report?
Tails just built Sonic a functional flying machine.
Alright, I think I have everything ready now. So, before I do anything, I will check what happens, what would happen if I were to plug in the power cable. Because, if I'm right, then the right thing should happen here. I just realized that I put, and I stood my case upside down for a moment, just a moment. So here we go. Turn on the power supply. There should be an LED somewhere. not really seeing it, maybe it's under the chip. Luck. That would be my luck. Is there any reason why this shouldn't work right now? Oh, shit. What if I press this? Well, okay, there's no light that comes on right when the power supply is plugged in, but if I can turn this, you can see that the fans LEDs are on and the fans are spinning. Of course, all of them are. And, yeah, they are kind of silent, at least completely, but I think it will do for us for now, because it's not plugged into any video sources right now, so I will turn that right back off. I think I'll actually remove the power supply board for a moment yet again, because apparently there was one thing that I missed. When it comes to plugging front panel stuff into the motherboard, and that was the audio thing, HD audio it says, so let me find that. Well, let me have a quick look around to make sure that that is in fact the last thing. And that I'm not missing anything else. And now that I know that it works, I'll use some twisty ties to tie some of the cables around in the back.
There's a priestess in Ohio, a liar to the crowd. Monsters stood behind the gun, with the trousers down. They victimize Republicans and hate the pulpit road. It's time to stop the drama cast, send the bastard home. The stand the eye you see now, they had the bloody day. They brutalize and torture our men in passing grey. They abuse and corner women and the children. In uniform, send them all away. The people, they have suffered now for far too many years. The gas and plastic bullets from the batons, shepherd's spears. The time has come of Britain, in this camp they not see. The Spandy Chinese trainers, not for peace and liberty. Ah, the Spandy, are you seen now? They've had the bloody day. In uniform, send them all away. They stand the Arisina, they've had the bloody day.
Okay, and now let me see. Apparently I had plugged in the audio thing, but it somehow got loose again. So I think I pressed it well enough now that hopefully won't happen again, so let me see. I think I'm gonna cut the video for this, since so the rest of this will just be, well, not cut the video entirely, but cut the camera for this so that I can, I don't know, put that up there. There we go. so that I can just soundboard audio, because I don't have a sound card or anything. So that I don't have, well, I guess the audio stuff that's for the front panel audio, more than anything. That's what I plugged in, but I'm going to go ahead and unplug this TV that I'm using from the laptop that I'm streaming off of, and plug it into this thing right after I place the panels back on the thing. And see if we have BIOS screen going on. And then if that goes well, then it's time to install the OS, and with any luck in about an hour or two more tops, then we should be able to do some pretty cool shit with this. So let me go ahead and get the panels back on. Well, before I cut the video, hang on. Something that you might not have seen is that, okay, the back panel is on, but the front panel... the front panel does have this little window. I don't know if you can appreciate that, but it's a bit of a tinted, kind of smoky window that you can see stuff through. So the LED should shine through. That's kind of a neat detail. I don't know where I'm gonna put this, that's kind of thing, so I had to get rid of to put the optical drive in, but oh well. And we'll keep that around. Both of the things are on, okay. It doesn't have any vent holes on the sides, however it does have some vents on the front, and top and the bottom, and the bottom one comes with a dust filter in case. Here's a fan for the power supply is facing upside down, so that's the ventilation, I suppose. And it does come with some kind of a bulging sides too, since that kind of makes cable management a little easier in the back of the panel. The back of the case, I guess. Which is where all the wires are supposed to be right up through to avoid making too big of a mess. And luckily that worked out pretty well for now, so let me see. What I'm gonna do now is, okay, probably not gonna be able to reach it because I need to unplug that. Yes, I need to unplug my PC from, well, my laptop from the TV. It says PC when on the channel for the TV when I unplug that, so that's the reflex. And unlock the video, I think. Plug the VGA thing from the back of the TV as well. So let me get that. I think the way I'll be doing it is DVI to HDMI. Should work acceptably well with any luck, and if not, I'll just switch back to VGA. Since, VGA would serve me well enough. Since this TV can only do up to like 720p. Right, the computer is on the floor. I've just plugged in the video, now I just need to plug in the power. And change the source. And turn it on and see what happens. Okay, the fans are spinning and LEDs are on, and I'm waiting for an output of image here. That wasn't the wrong source. Right, no, never mind. I picked the right one. Reboot and select road. Okay. I think I might need to reboot or I need to get some input in there as well. I forgot about that. Need to plug in the mouse and keyboard on.